दिस थिंग इज फाइनली हैपनिंग राइट, हैविंग द सिट बैक कॉन्वर्सेशन इन फ्रंट ऑफ कैमरा एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट ट्रैवल एक्सपीरियंस. Oh God, I had actually thought for it years back. Here we go for our first sit-back video and let me give you introduction about what just happened few hours back. Today morning when I woke up, I was under the zone that dude, are you actually going to wake up early, get ready and show up in front of camera? And for what? For sharing information that you got through your experience? Oh God, I always wanted to do this. So let's begin with our first sit-back travel video.
Welcome to
Travelpedia!
Talk upon the topic number one, accommodation. There are fair enough accommodation facilities available in Saputara. Not that I would say a lot in sequence, because majorly Saputara is not very much commercialized. And honestly speaking, I love that part of Saputara. Now, if you ask for couch surfing, Airbnb, or let's just say you are planning to go for hitchhiking there, it's pretty much moderate and not a considerably advisable thing for you. Coming to topic number two regarding food, starting from Lapino's to Jani No Locho or some random Punjabi restaurant, you are sorted in the context of food, and rather I would really recommend that you check out the street food also. Topic number three, weather. Talking with a local, I could understand that starting from the month of May, going till the month of December, it's a perfect time to visit Saputara with your family and with your friends. Topic number four, also the last one, transportation. I want to take a moment to thank and appreciate Gujarat government for developing amazing roads as well as parking slot availability. It's all sorted and you're good to go. And here we are to talk for a very crucial, sensitive, and rather I would say a controversial, everything together kind of a topic regarding trekking in Saputara. Alright, so you might be wondering, why did I use those terms, or rather might even be curious to know what exactly did I mean by those words. Let me just explain myself. All of these things are coming out of my experience. You may get your sit back and listen to what I want to convey. So the thing is, please choose an appropriate trekking organization to get your best of the trekking experience. Now, why am I telling this thing? Let me give you the explanation, and please do let me know in the comment section below if you are agreeing with this whole part. Now, the thing is, in Saputara, the tourism is at its top level. Understood. Out of which many travel organization and travel agents are making people get here for giving the trekking experience, in spite of not having appropriate knowledge of how to make everybody trek or rather hike. Now that is what I could clearly notice everywhere. For this whole trip, make sure that you are keeping an umbrella with you, or rather a raincoat, because the weather changes here very drastically. For a second it is raining and later on there is sun out there. So it's very much dicey, and for your safety, follow the instructions I'm giving. Topic number two, weather. Starting from the May month till the mid of July, when the rainfall has not happened in Saputara, it is an amazing period to go and trek there. Once the heavy rainfall happens, the whole place gets slippery and trekking gets a bit scary too, because weather is not supportive. The whole place where we were staying was also muddy. That's fine, it happens. It's a part and parcel of when you're getting there on a monsoon trek. So that is the thing. I would not recommend that you go for a monsoon trek over rather any mountains, or even if you're going, please go through a proper trekking organization who provides you proper instructions and who has appropriate instructor to guide you during that period. Moj Tourism was kind enough to collaborate with me and giving me best of the trekking experience. I have given all the information in the bio for their contact details. Feel free to contact them and they will make sure that you get the best of the experience and also make sure that you are informing them that you have come through the team of Capturing You. Hello, here are all the accommodations. This is the place where we are going to stay for the upcoming 2 whole days. And also, Moj Tourism has made sure that we are not having any hurdles or issues. We are given all the support and all the facilities. So that's a good sign. Overview of my trekking experience in Saputara. Definitely, hands down, I would recommend that you trek in Saputara. Of course, keeping all the points already priorly mentioned here in my video. And you are good to go. I hope this video has helped you. Please like, share, comment as well as subscribe to my channel. I am getting motivated for making creative videos all the time and I really hope this piece of information in the video has helped you a lot. Thank you so much. Until then, see you next time. Bye-bye.